Thank you. strange faces.
Between cobblestone and excretion.
Walk blessed.
Ah, there you are. Did you find it?
Yes, here. But be careful, okay?
Thou art my light, my glimmer at the horizon.
It's hoping no.
Yes.
Yes? Hello? Here you go looking for a stone, and you simultaneously solve an Enderlean mystery. Good work. I had read theories about what happened to the Count, but this is not what I had imagined. I wonder what became of that girl. Huh. Seems as if a part of the stone's energy really was vanished into her body. Just look at it. It's somehow duller than the others. But still, it shouldn't make a difference. Anyhow, let's see if we were right. Fascinating. Truly fascinating. Well, exactly what we thought would happen, I wager. The stone connected with the beacon. And what a connection it was. I've never seen such energy, let alone felt it. But be that as it may, half a chicken doesn't make a cake. We still need two more stones. Yes? Oh my. That is horrible. I knew Dalgais wasn't exactly a paragon of virtue, but to abandon one's son simply because... I will never understand those sorts of people. But still, this tragedy tells us we were right about our theory regarding the stones. To destroy the village and make this boy suffer, that is perfidious, truly perfidious. At least all that suffering wasn't in vain. Let us insert the stone. This is a better place for all that energy to be than in the hands of some poor souls the High Ones are looking to poison. Only one more stone to go now, Puffet. Hello. Oh, by the righteous path. His own sister? Oh, I had heard about those murders. It's cruel, truly cruel. Why in blazes are the High Ones doing this? I think, but I just can't find an answer. Maybe. At least we now have all the stones. Let us complete the mosaic. By the left path! What power! If we could really direct this and use it against the Highlands, it might work. It just might work. Now are we... Wait a minute. You feel that? Something's different. The sea of eventualities. I can't feel it anymore. No, I don't think so. It's like a veil put in front of my eyes. This doesn't bode well. It truly does not. Shaorin. He's currently trying to raise the barriers. The ones at the gates. They are meant to magically seal them as a protection against Korak's armies. The walls are nearly impenetrable, but the gates aren't. Shaorin said he would raise entropical barriers to take care of it. Quickly, go see him and find out what is going on. I will secure the beacon as best I can. Go!
Keep walking.
I tell you it won't work. I can't see anything.
But why? That just doesn't make any sense.
Well spotted.
slow thinkers among us, I recognize a magic blockade when I see one. And as long as it is active, we can't put up the barrier.
I understand that you're upset, but an order is an order. I'm sorry.
What is going on?
Thank the sun, Harrenthiel. I'm trying in vain to make this highly intelligent commander of yours understand that these headaches are not arbitrary.
Oh, Grandmaster,
you're not from around here, are you?
Shireen is right, Commander. Something
accent.
Is wrong. We...
What the...
The Nuromis are inside the city! They're inside the city, dammit!
Prophetess! Come here!
Prophetess.
The Nuromis are inside the King's Bay. Their ships, they...
Yes.
Just appeared!
Yes.
I don't understand.
They just appeared? Are you trying to tell us that an entire fleet entered our harbor and nobody noticed it?
Of course. They cast an invisibility spell on their fleet. The magical blockade prevented us from recognizing. Good plan. Thanks to the utterly capable military around here, one that worked out perfectly.
Watch your mouth, wild mage. Nobody...
Come on. It does not matter how it happened. We must act quickly. Shall we? Is the spell for the barrier of the gates ready?
One at the main gate, yes. But until now, we couldn't cast it because of the blockade. Can I give the signal?
Yes. They want us to panic. But we will not do them the favor. Activate the barrier, then return to us. Soldier, you said that the Nuromis have already invaded the city. To what extent?
They're in the fog district, I think. They overran the harbor gate before we were able to close it. But Sergeant Harlechen has entrenched himself at the gate of the lower district. He won't be able to hold it for long.
Good. Come on, station your soldiers on the battlement. And use arrows to keep the Nuromis at a distance. Don't let them get close to the market. You, Prophetess, will accompany me there. We will liberate the south quarter and then secure the harbor gate, so that Shireen will be able to place a barrier there as well. At least the heart of the city will be safe then.
You're going to fight?
Yes. Now go. Time is of the essence.
Understood. Soldier, follow me.
Are you ready? Magic, as Shireen said. They've put a spell on their fleet to make it invisible. Probably the doing of Gorek's mute bodyguard. I've heard stories about him, and I fear they have infiltrated us in secret too. But we won't discuss this now. Are you ready? Good. We need to find Sergeant Harlechen. The soldier said he's in the south quarter. Follow me. Bastards. They will pay for this. Infiltrators, just as I suspected.
Secure the damn gate!
Sergeant Harlechen.
Who?
Grand Master Aranthio. It is an honor.
The honor is mine. What is the gate's status?
Dozens of Naramis are behind this gate, and they're setting up rams.
Then we will stop them. We have to secure the harbor gate at all costs. Once we have done that, our mages will seal the gate. This is all of you, I take it?
For now, yes. But reinforcements are on the way. Forgive my failure, Master. We should have seen it coming, but everything just happened so quickly.
I know. Now come on, we march out. Every second we wait will help the enemy.
Yes, sir. Guard, the Grand Master is relying on us, and so is Malphus. Live up to your names.
Yes, sir.
Go.
It's jammed, Sergeant!
What? What are you talking about?
Is it possible that the Naramis have sabotaged the mechanism?
Sabotage? Yes, of course, that must be it. What can...
The locking mechanisms of the gate are on both sides of the wall, correct?
Yes. Yes, Master, that's right.
Good. Prophetess, you and I will fix the cranks. Sergeant, in the meantime, you and your men will keep the Naramis off the gate. When we are finished, we will give the signal for retreat. Understood?
Yes, Master, of course. Get him. Omar, prepare the cannon. Let's show the bastards what it means to defy the Lightborn. We will await your signal, Grandmaster. May his light guide you.
And you. Follow me, Prophetess, to the beacon. There are two cranks with which the portcullis is controlled. One can be reached by following the left hallway, the other one is to the right. We do not know if the Naramis have already sabotaged both mechanisms, but I suppose so. You take the left crank, I will take the one on the right. Once that is done, you will return to the city gate. Understood? I'm sure they're trying their best to do just that, but it will take time. The defense mechanisms of Ark are more than solid. Let's not push our luck, however. Go!
Hurry up, dammit!
I am hurrying.
You chose your fate!
You now will not live stop with us! Costume. Never!
There they are. Gil, Nara, prepare the fire spitter.
Now,
retreat! Now!
Conquering the gate didn't go as well as planned, did it? What happened here?
Nothing. Secure the gate.
As you wish. However, seems we have a visitor.
Teodor Aranfield on the battlefield. I must confess, I am surprised. Oh my, look at these poor fools, trusting you until the end. It seems you still value human life as little as you did back in Kira. How many people was it, Aranfield? I have forgotten.
Wise words from the mouth of a warmonger.
Oh, so that is what I am to you. If I remember correctly, it was you who refused to negotiate. You might not believe it, but I enjoy this no more than you do. Hence, one more time, Aranfield, surrender. Your so-called army is a joke compared to mine, and it is merely a matter of time until we find a way into the city. So, for once in your life, make the right call and end this conflict before it gets even bloodier than it is now.
Well said, Quark. So, what do you expect us to do now? Ask in your wisdom? Kneel before you?
Yaslan Sharin, how disappointing to see you here. All your life you have fought religion and its tentacles, and now you fight for it.
I fight for something called common sense. Should try it sometime.
As I said, Aranfield, last chance. Stop working on the beacon and no one will be harmed. The cleansing has to happen and you will not stop it.
Trust me, I will.
Now, is that all?
It is.
It is.
Alma, line up the prisoners. I want to see each one of them crucified before nightfall. And then inform the troops. Every Enderlean will be killed on sight.
Understood.
What? Religion is a sickness, Aranthiel. And it is the cause of pretty much all the evil that has happened in this world over the past millennia. Your son saw that too, unlike you. But he also made a fatal mistake. To believe that the death of the Lightborn was going to change things. But they were just a symptom, not the cause of the sickness. The cause is religiosity itself, this particular way of thinking. Oh, believe me, my train of thought is more rational than you might think. Religious people choose irrationality above reason, and dogmas above free thinking. They turn themselves into puppets, and by doing this, they are responsible too. And your behavior, Aranthiel, is the last proof I needed. Believe me, I wish there were another way, but you have shown me that there isn't. The High Ones will never elevate us until the ulcer of religiosity has been torn from every single head in this world. I've tried the peaceful way, but you don't seem to want it. Now live with the consequences. By the way, it's good to see that you have survived. What's about to happen now is your fault, Aranthiel. Don't even try to convince yourself otherwise.
Take this. We need to go back to the temple. As soon as Sharin and the Arcanists have cast the seal on the door, it will be as safe as it can get, yes. But let us talk in the temple. And lead that entropist right into the city. Their death was necessary. It was an honor for them. We will proceed as planned. Light the beacon as soon as possible. That is all that matters. So, how long do you need to seal the gate?
An hour?
Good. Be quick about it. Garton, what is the situation in the other districts? Are all of the intruders dead?
Yes, Grandmaster.
Some of the infiltrators have fled into the sewers, but we're in pursuit.
Good. Tell the commander that I want all corpses to be disposed of before nightfall, and let repairs start as soon as possible. We are protected from intruders, but we have to beware of a panicking crowd inside. Then tell her to place archers and fire breathers on every battlement. Their arcanists will try to break the seals, but we won't let them.
Understood, Grandmaster.
Now then, let us go.
The righteous path, you are well.
What happened to Jorik? And why in blazes do you stand around like bloody waxwork figures?
Jorik has betrayed us, Teal'c.
What?
He has revealed the locations of our scouting posts to Korek's army. That's why we didn't see their ships coming. A keeper has caught him talking to Korek through one of the silver plates. And don't worry, he's only unconscious.
Commander, get him out of here.
Of course, Grandmaster. Where should I take him?
Anywhere, for heck's sake!
We will deal with him later. This is not a case for the Tribunal.
Very well, Grandmaster.
What is the status of the beacon? Where is Marigil?
At the beacon. And there is a problem with your machine. But that's something they should tell you themselves. Now, excuse me, the entire city is in panic. The people expect an explanation.
Then give them one. Follow me, Prophetess, to the beacon.
I don't care, damn it. Just do it.
Tell you there's no word about Numenos.
Well, if you say so, then I guess we have to get used to the idea that our machine will not glow anytime soon.
What are you talking about? We have the stones.
Grandmaster. Yes, that is right. We have the stones, and they give the beacon the energy it needs, as we had assumed. But
this crystal in the middle of the cross, it is the core of the machine. The Numenos.
So?
The Numenos is empty, Grandmaster. That's why it is so dark. If we were to ignite the beacon now, its energy would be emitted aimlessly, with devastating results.
An explosion, to be precise. An enormous one. No, it's more than that. The beacon can defeat the High Ones. The more we learn about it, the more certain we become. However, it needs a target, a kind of focal point. And if we ignite it without one, things will become very uncomfortable. Unfortunately, we don't have a lot of experience in building Pyrian machines. So, yes, indeed, we had not noticed it before. So it seems, yes.
I am very sorry, Grandmaster. We should have seen it come to
us as soon as possible.
Yes, and before you ask, we don't know yet what the Numenos actually is, and neither do we know where to search for it.
But we will find a way. Give us a week, maybe two, and there will be results, I assure you.
Then begin, Prophetess. Get some rest. You'll need it.
Oh my. Such chaos.
Yes, I think so. But right now, we can't do anything but read the writings from old Dothu Grant for the umpteenth time. Poking with some clue we might have missed before. Yes, he did. Even though he was one of the closest confidants of the Grand Master, I don't know what to say. Not really. But it was no secret that he regarded the Grand Master's actions against the Nerunese as careless. He does not seem to understand that the beacon is our only chance. Yes, I guess. You should take a rest. I was told what you did to secure the gate. We'll call you as soon as we need your help.
Yeah, that's just how it is.
Huh? Can I help you?
Look, I don't have time for chit-chat. Make yourself useful. Help defend the city or do something to keep the Nerunese outside. The keepers say the walls and those barriers at the gate will hold, but I'd rather drink Vatir's piss than put trust into some entropist witchcraft.
Good evening.
Oh, you're here. I didn't know you were on patrol today, too.
Aye. Normally I wouldn't be, but Zawin's wife got sick, so I pitched in for him. How are things? Any troubles?
No. Nothing worth mentioning. There were these Killian sailors who got pretty...
Can I help you?
That's just how it is. Everything was better in the old days. Dressed up like some shit-faced I just don't respect the elders anymore. Not
and always making trouble. Anyway, keep your chin up, boy.
May your path always be even.
Walk blessed. It's good to see you.
Walk blessed.
Malfassi's blessings. Ah, that pretty boy you mean. Aye, I did. A couple of hours ago. Drank like there's no tomorrow, I tell you. No? Why would I? People don't usually check out here before they go. But if I was you, I'd go take a look at the other taverns round here. He sure didn't look like he was done drinking.
Is it important?
Foreigners.
Welcome to the Jewel of the Undercity. How may I be a service?
What are you doing here? Go ogle someone else.
Okay.
May your path always be even.
Await my safe return. Trust in this. promise and
tough
stay
times.
Firm once high.
Tough times.
Shines right onto the sea.
Foreigners.
Now there's a treat for the eye. What do you say, darling?
Want
to spend some time together?
Dam, you look as though you have a kind heart. Please, spare a penny for me. Just one.
Now look at that. If it isn't the holy prophetess. What are you doing here? Looking for some fun? Hey, what the heck is wrong with you? Don't be a prick. You are way too serious sometimes, you know that? There are times when you just have to indulge. I am enjoying myself. You should try that for a change, you know. Who knows how much time there's left for that? What are you doing here, anyway? Ah, right. Talking. Talking is good. Or is it? I forgot. Maybe I can't, yeah. Or maybe I don't give a fuck about Adela. Maybe I don't give a fuck about any of you. And I'm just waiting for the right moment to stab you all in the back. Who knows? That's the great thing about life. You can never tell exactly which way the wind blows. Oh, I'm not. What if what you're seeing here is my true self? Hmm? And if it was, would you still bother pretending to care? Nah, you wouldn't. I think if you really knew me, you'd have been long gone. Friends, you just don't want to get it, do you? Let me think how I can make myself more clear. Three words. I don't care. I don't care where my jobs come from and what I have to do as long as I'm getting paid. I don't care if the beggar in the front of the tavern eats his own shit as long as I can enjoy my beer inside. And I don't care if people who think they're important to me kick the fucking bucket because I just don't care. Adela's dead? Fuck it. At least that means there's no one around anymore who knows what I really am. Lucia, she was the first one. I took what I wanted from her, and when it got too tiresome, I just left her behind. Like all the others, before and after her. Have you never wondered why I'm by myself? Loyalty, friendship, love, it's bullshit. We're born alone, we live alone, and we die alone. And I seem to be the only one who fucking sees it. Ashes to ashes, dust to dust. The High Ones. Yeah, those goddamn High Ones. When those thugs killed our family, she was so hurt, so lost, you know? But do you think I did anything to help her? All I cared about was myself. What Adela did, what she became, That didn't just happen overnight. I always felt that something was wrong with her, how she kept on withdrawing from the outside world, reading all these stupid books my father always read. But I never went to see her. I never wrote her. And you know why? Not because there wasn't time for it. Not because I couldn't cope with it myself. I didn't because I couldn't be bothered. Couldn't bother with her moodiness. Didn't bother with all the drama. I just couldn't care less. Just as I didn't give a fuck about Lycia. We were on a mission in Goldenforst, and had just set up camp for the night. That was a couple of nights after we realized that we had different expectations, so to speak. I went to get firewood, and when I came back, there were half a dozen bandits in the camp. Lycia was out cold. She was still alive. I saw it. She was alive, but I just ran. I just turned around and fucking ran. Does it matter? I didn't even consider fighting, not for a moment. Why? Because I never gave a shit about people, even if they were deluded enough to think otherwise. It's just like Adila said. My life revolves around one thing, and that is me. Jaspar. The navel of the fucking universe. Tell that to Lycia. Do you think it was any different with us? I saw you and felt there'd be money in helping you. And if that Korak had offered me my life against yours, do you think I would even think twice? You think we're friends, or whatever, but we aren't. If that's what you want to believe, go ahead. You think I'm something that I'm not. Something I never was. I'm a sellsword, not one of the good guys. And you think that you know me, but you don't. Adila and Lycia, that's just the tip of the iceberg. Now, please, just go, okay? I need to get away from here. From this city, from these people, from everything.
A real pretty thing. Now there's a treat for the eye. What do you say, darling? Want to spend some time together?
Mm-hmm.
Walk blessed.
Yes.
One more time. Why did you kill Pegast?
The Grand Master and the Prochessa do not want to be disturbed. I'm sorry,
the prophetess found a bottle of cap dust.
Good work in the harbor, really.
How do you explain that?
Well, maybe there are thousands of dust addicts in the city, and not just me.
Damn it.
Yes, I gave Korek the locations of our outposts, but I had nothing to do with the death of that woman.
Then at least tell us who else Korek bought. Who hired the mercenaries in Old Rationgrad?
I don't know. And even if I did, I wouldn't tell you. And do you know why? Because this war is madness, Teal'c. It is madness. It is unnecessary. And you are too fucking blind to see it.
I am blind? Which of us is the traitor? Which of us is responsible for the deaths of hundreds and hundreds of people?
Let's stick to the point. Accusations lead us nowhere.
A word of wisdom from your mouth, Natara. Bravo.
Pity that your wisdom doesn't go beyond words. Weren't you always the most determined of the three of us? For 3 decades you led this country, and you never showed any weakness.
But no. As soon as the grand, presumed dead Teal'c Aranthiel returns, all you do is bow and scrape. Why, Natara? Have you too come to believe that pile of scrap metal out there can save us? Whatever that's supposed to look like. Or do you do it because Teal'c warmed your bed back in the day?
You are only making it worse.
Oh, am I? You are so bloody blind. Blind and stupid. Both of you. Don't you realize how much of a fool this Korek really is? His only condition for peace was that we would stop rebuilding some ancient machine. What would that have cost us? Nothing. But no, Teal'c. To you, this fantasy of cycles and high ones is more important. More important than anything else. Damn it, even your own people.
Fantasy. So you still believe that the threat is not real? After all that has happened?
I don't know. I'm a warrior, not a sage. But even if it is real, what I do know is that we can only lose this war, and that we will dig more graves with each day we wage it. Up here we are safe, yes, but what about the villages, the farmers? Don't get me wrong, Teal'c. I know what I did, but sometimes a quick cut is better than bleeding out slowly. Korek would have conquered the city. We would have surrendered, and maybe he would have even shown mercy. But it's too late for that now.
No. You didn't do this for our country or our people. You did it because you wanted to save your own skin. Nothing more and nothing less. And yes, Jorik, maybe you are right. Maybe we can't win this war. But that doesn't mean I will surrender. Because I have something that you don't. Principles. You don't have any. You have nothing but your bottle of booze and your bloody dust. You are a hollow man, without talent. And the only reason you are here, and not in the alleys of the Undercity, is your bloodline. And now, people are dead, all because of your cowardice. Do not think I will ignore that for old times' sake. I will count to 3. Who else has Korek bought? 1.
Now aren't you a tough guy, Teal'c?
2.
What I did was right. One day you'll realize this too, and then you will be ashamed for you just...
3. We are.